Members of the jury, by the oath which you have just taken, you have sworn to try this case on the evidence. You must shut out from your minds everything except what will take place in this court. You may proceed for the...
This is murder.
Murder!
Murder!
Murder! Well, that will is practically an invitation to commit murder. Murder!
It was a rainy night, and all the windows were tight. There were 13 people in the house. The owner and his wife, the butler and his wife, cook with her knife, a couple named Smythe. The Andersons were there with another strange pair, and the scary caretaker and me. The clock struck one, there was the sound of a gun, and I heard somebody run away. 12 were alive, had terror in their eyes, and I overheard the Andersons say,
who could have done it? Who could have done it? And I wonder, where's the crook in a knife?
Madam, said Adam, with his wife by his side, it was the shot we heard that took her life. The other couple named Sloan, and I ran to the phone to call the police. Just then, all the power went out, and we heard a great shout, and we knew for someone else was the end. When the power came on, we were shocked with alarm, for instead of being 12, we were 10.
Who could have done it? Who could have done it? The Andersons are such a nice pair.
Now the owner and his wife both afraid for their life, so they hurried to the door to run away. But before they got there, there was a whistle through the air, then another, then they both had passed away. There were 7 of us left now, afraid of death now, but I knew it wasn't me or the Sloans. 'Cause when the power went out and we heard the other shout, we were out there in the hallway on the phone. That left the butler and his wife and the couple named Smythe and the old scary caretaker too. So the Sloans and I, who were both afraid to die, had to think of something quick we could do. So we called the Smythes and the butler and his wife, and we gathered in the drawing room. But before we could call for the caretaker too, it was too late, for he had met his doom. It looked like poison. That left 5 were still alive, the Sloans, the Smythes, and myself. And once again the lights went out, and I heard a great shout from both the Smythes and the Sloans. And then the lights came on again, and I looked around again, and everybody was dead, and I was alone. The next thing I knew, I was awakened with my hands in chains. There was a man with a gun, and he said, don't bother, son, you'll have plenty of time to explain. I was rushed to a car, then taken to a cell, and a lawyer came in and said his name. He said, I'm sure you told the truth.
Well, the truth is, my boy, to believe it, the judge would be insane.
Now, before I pass sentence on you, have you anything to say?
And I said, are you kidding?
I said, this must be a dream. I said, this can't be real. You don't believe a word that I've said. And then he looked me in the eye and said, have mercy on his soul. And I was hanged by the neck until death. Hey, wait a minute. Hey, stop. Hey, would you mind rewinding that last sentence? I mean,
nothing to get hung up about. I mean, you should be in here. Hey, you ever hear the word appeal? Well, I'm about to appeal you off that bench in a minute.